In this chapter, you will learn about CarMaker Simulink plugins. In comparison to the code simulation between CarMaker and Simulink, Simulink Coder is used to convert your model into C code. You can then add it to CarMaker as a plugin without establishing a code simulation between the two tools. The advantages are just a minor loss in performance, even though MATLAB Simulink techniques are used, no C code experience is required, and it's platform independent. The drawback, however, is that every change in your model requires a new build process. So how is the Simulink plugin model for CarMaker created? The workflow starts by generating a source folder. This can easily be done by checking the source build environment box in the project creation or project update menu. We can optionally choose to add the Simulink Coder RTW examples from the installation directory or leave it empty. After clicking the OK button, the source folder appears in our well-known project folder and can be accessed by MATLAB. After opening a suitable MATLAB version, we navigate to the project folder. And in order to add the CarMaker path to the MATLAB search path, we have to run the CarMaker environment script cmenv.m at the beginning. Now we have to access the CarMaker for Simulink library in the Simulink library browser. We do that by going to Simulink, opening, for example, a blank model, and then the library browser. Inside the CarMaker for Simulink block set, double-click the Create Plugin Model button. This opens this new dialog in which we can select the target architecture, vehicle class, and model type. There are templates available for all CarMaker model classes. And the template plane can be used for any model class that does not exist in CarMaker, for instance, wipers or window lifters. But be careful when using this plane wrapper, because additional changes on C code level are necessary. These changes are documented in the CarMaker Programmer's Guide. For this demonstration, I'm going to select the Vehicle Control Model class. I'll now define the model name as Indicator Assist _RTW, and the same for the model description. The description itself will be shown in the drop-down menu of the CarMaker vehicle dataset later on. After a click on the Create button, a new Simulink model is generated. It contains the interface blocks, which are typical for the model class Vehicle Control. We have to map all signals so that they are transferred to the next blocks inside the CarMaker main cycle. Therefore, at first, check the Out interface block on the right for possible ports. Make all of them available. In the left bus selector, provide all the signals that can be put out by the right interface port. Select these as well, and then click the Select button. The target now is to match each input to the corresponding output. Check real quick if they match. And then we can start implementing our model. In the CarMaker for Simulink tutorial, the logic behind the indicators was introduced. Its task is to automatically activate the indicator lights in case the steering wheel angle exceeds 0.3 radians. I'll now implement this model between the interface blocks. I connect the output of the model to the indicator output port and take the steering angle as an input for our model. And then, let's also not forget to terminate the internal signals. Some more words about the model settings. Under CarMaker, there's the option Hook up model into project source code. That means that all the functions are added and registered to the source code automatically. Please keep in mind that the Simulink coder creates C code from the model in the first step. Automatic make in a project source directory means that it compiles and links the newly created C code and creates a new CarMaker executable in the second step automatically. The Simulink coder can be found under Apps. Here we have a button to start a new build process. In case there are any errors during the build process, just take a look at the diagnostic viewer. In this example, the build process was completed successfully. We can find the new CARM executable in the project folder under Source. After the build process, MATLAB is not needed anymore and can be closed. After closing MATLAB, I'll have to repeat one more time. We do not use CarMaker for Simulink this time in the co-simulation coupling, but CarMaker standalone instead. Under Application and then Configuration/Status, the newly generated CarMaker executable can be connected and started. In this window, we find some general information like the CarMaker version. Under Compile Info, we can see that the Indicator Assist library is included. We can also find the creation date of the executable there. I will now demonstrate the new plugin model using a prepared test run. In the Vehicle dataset, go to the Vehicle Control menu. And inside the Model Manager, choose the Indicator Assist plugin model. As I now start the simulation, you can see the Indicator Assist in action. Every time the steering wheel is turned to the left or the right more than 0.3 radians, the indicator lights will start to blink. The same plugin model is usable for different vehicles as well. Let me just choose one. Get back inside the vehicle control menu and choose the plugin model. Close and start again. There we go.